All right, very good. Let's build our model. Here, we've simply linked the estimated initial investment available in the driver's page. Depending on who carries out the modeling exercise, some people consider this a best practice. Others don't. But we've linked these cells to allow us to see them at all times, which will make explanations much easier. As you can see, the company must make an initial investment between 320 and 380 million euro. The estimated useful life of the plant is 10 years. For simplicity, we'll assume all assets the company will invest in will be depreciated in 10 years. That's not how things work in practice usually, as there are different asset categories, but this will be a good enough approximation for the calculation we're making here. Below, we have an additional input. This is the investment plan, which shows us how much of the initial investment will be spent throughout the years. The company will spend 100% of its investment in years 0, 1, and 2, and then we'll simply plan an additional spend of 3% for recurring CapEx needs. Okay? Good. It's time for some calculations. Here we have the classic fixed asset roll-forward table. Beginning property, plant, and equipment, plus capital expenditures, less D&A for the year, equals ending PP&E. Beginning PP&E in year 1 would be the investment to sustain to build the plant in year 0. Therefore, we must multiply 80% by the investment amount in the three scenarios. Please note, we'll be using the choose function to model the selected case. Choose works easily. Based on its index value, it will provide us a value associated with the first, second, or third case. This allows us to build scenarios in our models and make them flexible. Okay, excellent. Then we can continue by calculating CapEx in year 1. It will be given by the percentage we have in our investment plan for year 1 times the overall project investment. To calculate D&A, we must build a complete D&A schedule. D&A will be different in year 1, in year 2, and in year 3. Why? Well, every year we sustain an additional amount for CapEx, right? Even after year 2, we'll spend 3% per year to improve the plant. Therefore, we need a schedule that will show us precisely how much depreciation has been accumulated each year. The amount we've invested in year 1 is depreciated over 10 years, so we can easily divide it by 10 and show how much of it will be depreciated each year. The rest of the CapEx is not sustained yet, so this will be our D&A for year 1. Now, we've completed the table for year 1 and obtained closing PP&E for year 1, which is also our beginning PP&E for year 2, given that every year's closing PP&E is the beginning PP&E for the next one. We can then use the same formula as the one we have on the left to calculate CapEx for the entire table. This leaves us with D&A as the only unknown. Well, D&A is easy to calculate. All we have to do is calculate the additional depreciation of the investments we've made throughout the years. So for example, in year 1 we spent 38 million for CapEx, and 3.8 million euro of this amount will be depreciated every year until the rest of the projection period. And then the D&A amount for year 2 is equal to the sum of the D&A for CapEx sustained in year 0 and D&A for CapEx sustained in year 1. Makes sense, doesn't it? All we have to do is continue the formulas and we can complete our fixed asset roll-forward schedule. That's awesome! In our next lesson, we'll deal with working capital. Thanks for watching.